that it seemed like he lost a beloved person, and he was inquiring about patience and how can one practice patience. In one beautiful hadith, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهِ, which means, whosoever seeks patience and tries to practice patience and acquire the great quality of as-sabr, يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهِ, Allah will make him a patient one, will make him endure patiently calamities, given sorrow moments and events. Why? Because he took the initiative. And there is a great indication in this hadith. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith began by saying, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلُّمُ وَإِنَّمَا الْحِلْمُ بِالتَّحَلُّمُ. If you would like to become a scholar and a learned person, you have to acquire knowledge. If you like to acquire a good quality, you have to practice it. And truly, it is not possible for any person to enroll in any scheme or any system or any course to get a degree or to earn a quality or to be qualified for something unless he or she realizes the virtues of that certificate, of this achievement. The achievement of patience or as-sabr is the only achievement which has reward without limit. For each virtue, for each ibadah, for each good deed, there is a set reward. But when it comes to patience, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجَرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Most certainly, only الصابرين, the patient ones, shall receive their compensation, the reward. How much? بغير حساب, without limit, open fund. This is a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, give the good news and the glad tidings to the patient ones, الصابرين, الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Those whomever they are afflicted with a calamity or tested with a musiba, they say, the remark, their statement is not an objection. Rather, it is to say, most surely, we all belong to Allah and unto Him we shall return. You broke a glass, a window, you got in a car collision, you lost a beloved one, you lost a limb in an operation, whatever. These are all items which do belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ, we all belong to Allah, and unto Him we shall return. For them, what kind of bishara or glad tiding which is delivered in this ayah?
أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ.
Such people, the patient ones. عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them, will have mercy on them, and they are the truly guided ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst them. Al-Iman, half of patience, half of faith is patience. So when the person recognizes the magnificent reward, which as we mentioned earlier, is without limit in patience, then whenever he or she is afflicted with a musibah or a calamity, they remember the reward, which lies in enduring this calamity patiently, compared to the grief and the sorrow which they experience as a result of being afflicted with the calamity. So the reward outweighs any grief, any sorrow, any affliction. And that's why they take this as a chance to prove to themselves and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, indeed, we will be amongst as-sabirin. May Allah make us amongst them.